Hello, my friends. Happy December. It's almost Christmas. It's almost end of the year. This terrible year in the stock market, unless you've just been buying from January till now, which you're probably down even more, and you probably can't believe that. I want to talk about Sundial, and I really did not think I was going to make another Sundial video anytime soon. Last time I talked about Sundial, we were just on this $3 edge right here, and I was like, hey guys, I would be very careful buying at this high rate right now because we really don't know that Sundial is going to keep these numbers, and I highly doubt we're going to see a $4 mark. I'm hoping this goes to a $4 mark. Well, since that video, more news has been coming out here with Sundial. Sundial actually, since they went off this reverse split, they've been having some pretty positive news, and they've been doing what Sundial does. They've been investing their money by buying other companies as well. And like I've said before, this is really what, you know, grabs the attention of a lot of people that are investing in Sundial. This is fantastic. Now, obviously, we're knocking out the first week of December here. Stock market's been down. We really haven't seen much. It's Monday today. And Sundial is down today, but it, you know, last week it had a really good week, almost hitting around a 340 mark. We have not seen that in some time with Sundial. So this has been a very positive 2 weeks here. Now the big question is, you know, is Sundial going to keep skyrocketing here, or is it going to crash? And that's what a lot of people are saying. That's what we're seeing in articles. You know, personally, you know, I have to go with like the creatures of habit of the stock market here that, you know, I'm sure this week in the stock market will be, it's going to be okay. Next week will probably be a better week. And then after that, I truly expect the stock market to start crashing here a little bit because people are going to be selling out of things. Right now, we're seeing higher volume than a little normal because a lot of investors right now are really pushing to try to get out of things, to try to do as many short trades as they can, just to say, you know what, whatever I get here, I'm just going to get it and I'm going to get out and I'm going to write this off my taxes. My tax guy, he'll fix me. Whatever. I don't care. So that's why we usually expect stock market to crash a little bit going into the new year here. In January, everyone's broke. February, same excuse. And then people start getting their tax money. Then we start seeing everything kind of normalize again here. So this year alone, you know, we've already seen that Alcanna deal take place with Sundial, where they bought up Alcanna, which, you know, they mostly do a lot of alcohol, which is fabulous because, that's a billion-dollar industry we're talking about there. And Sundial is still putting their money in other cannabis companies, buying them up, trying to buy up their retailers, their stores, their customers. Sundial is really trying to be a really big cannabis company here because I've said this before, but let me break this down in the easiest way that I see it right now, is that we have all these cannabis companies and right now they're all fighting for the top seat. It's like Game of Thrones right now. You know, we've got so many right now. In one day, it's going to be legalized and everywhere where there's massive amount of money in North America. Well, North America, United States, it's going to be legalized everywhere. And that's going to be a huge market there. Huge. To where you could see a Sundial corner store. Who knows? Cannabis is getting more established, more well-known, more normalized each year and decriminalized each year at a very fast rate. So it's really a smart investment if you can find the right company that you want to invest in. You'd be crazy as an investor not to take the cannabis industry serious. So positives we know right now with Sundial. They have a lot of cash. They have no debt. They're buying companies. This coming year, friends, I'm going to be honest. I'm not making any kind of predictions. Being on YouTube, having a YouTube channel, watching the guys that I watch a lot of my heroes on YouTube that I'm sure a lot of you watch too, where we all had these thoughts and, you know, what the stock market was going to be in 2022 and 2021. You know, that all fell short. Things just kept getting worse here. So next year, we could just have another 2022 in our hands. We could have something better. We could have something worse. I don't know. As for Sundial's survival, it is looking good. And this is what we want to see. You know, the reverse split happened. It sucked. It really sucked. A lot of people got caught in it. I got caught in it. No one really got out of it without shedding some blood somewhere. But since we've had that, that is what reverse splits are meant to do. They're meant to reboot the stock, get it up, going, and running, and get investors excited about what's going on and bring on new investors. So, friends, with all that said, I just want to say, I'm sure I'll talk about Sundial again here, but, you know, buying Sundial at a, I don't know, you know, I think we're going to tank here going into the end of December, because if a lot of you that have been in the stock market, if you've been in the stock market for more than 1 year, you're probably agreeing with this, maybe, that December, the towards the end of it, is going to bring some low numbers, especially with this market we're seeing right now. So I'm kind of expecting to see Sundial fall right back under this hopefully high $2 mark. I'm hoping it holds around this 290, 320 maybe. That'd be fantastic. But I'm definitely not expecting $4, but it's definitely trying to get to that place. But like I said, I hope I'm wrong. I always hope I'm wrong. But I have to bring the realistic stick with the situation of, you know, what we know. But that's the fun thing about the stock market. It does what it wants to do, and it can always fool you. So, friends, I really do want to wish all of you luck. It's almost Christmas. I hope all of you are doing well. A crazy year, been a crazy few years in the market. And be careful what you're buying the next 2 weeks, because the next 2 weeks after that, towards the end of December, that's probably where we're going to really focus our money on investing. So, friends, once again, I really do wish all of you luck, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye, everyone.